What a great question. What's the best advice Rey Mysterio has ever given me? You know, Rey was instrumental in working with me very early on in my career. Performers like Rey really molded the way that I perform today, which is extremely improvisational and a lot based on how you feel.
I think one of the most important things that he's told me was after my first match against Seth at SummerSlam, I remember he hugged me and I asked him, I said, how was it? How did I do? And he was just like, you killed it, you did great. And then afterwards he just said, it only matters what you think. If you think you did good or the people around you think, he goes, whatever feedback it is that you're getting, he goes, that's what matters.
You know, some veterans or some guys who've been around as long as he has feel the need to take on this sort of mentor role, sometimes even unsolicited, and just offer advice left and right. But with Rey, I don't know. I feel like he's always treated me like a peer, which I think that is a huge compliment. He never talked down to me or never offered advice. And, you know, he just talks to you like you're on his level. And I don't think anybody's on his level, really. There's only one Rey Mysterio. There only ever will be one Rey Mysterio.
There's never been anybody in our industry that has worn a mask that can express emotion as well as Rey Mysterio. There was a match that he had, this is actually great because it's not ever talked about. So Rey was competing against TJ in 2010 on Superstars, literally a week before he was set to have a huge WrestleMania singles match in 2010. I can't even begin to tell you how excited Rey was about the opportunity to work with TJ, and TJ was like a kid in a candy shop. He was on cloud nine. Anybody who was anybody of influence watched the match, and they were just so, because of what Rey did for TJ and how much he let TJ shine, he literally like gave TJ this like WrestleMania moment when TJ wasn't even a part of that WrestleMania. Like, it makes me emotional talking about it because that's the kind of person that Rey is. He wants to have everybody that he's in there with shining. To this day, TJ will still pull up that match and watch it back, and he just thinks of that match as his WrestleMania moment. And it was because of Rey giving that match to TJ, and TJ having somebody that believed in him enough for him to rise to that occasion.
We're not gonna have another Rey Mysterio. Like, he's gonna be just Rey Mysterio and that's it. And I just feel that his legacy is gonna be untouchable. It's gonna be there forever. And I think he's still an inspiration to everyone, and he will be forever. Because now we have the internet and everyone can search for Rey Mysterio, and he's gonna find like everything of him. Everyone is gonna get like motivated like for the rest of the years from now.
At the time when I was training to become a wrestler, I was met with kind of this dilemma where I wanted to hide my background, if that made sense. I wasn't very open to the fact that I'm a Muslim and that my name is Mustafa Ali. So to hide that, the idea with who I was training with at the time was to put a mask on. Rey Mysterio is the luchador. So when I designed my first mask, a tribute to him I actually had was Rey's infamous for his wings coming over his mouth. And I have the same wings on my first luchador mask. And I just remember when I got into the ring, I said, I want to be like Rey Mysterio.
I can tell you that every time I'm around him, it's like a special thing for me. And I mean, I speak as myself. I think I can speak for the entire locker room. I don't think there's anybody in our locker room that's as respected as Rey is. And you know, obviously a lot of our longtime guys are very well respected, but Rey's like on another level. He's been around for so long, so everybody that's watched wrestling at any point is likely to have seen Rey Mysterio. But the thing about him that's special is even though he's been doing this for that long, you can watch a Rey Mysterio match now, and you can watch a Rey Mysterio match from 1997. It's the same stuff. The guy hasn't aged at all.
So it's funny, because whenever people ask me about my favorite wrestler growing up, it always rotates between three guys: Shawn Michaels, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, and Rey Mysterio. And for me, Rey is the one who actually made me believe that I could do this. Because there were so many people who told me that I was too small. They told me that I wasn't tall enough, I wasn't big enough, and I'd feel bad about it, you know, and then I'd like go home and I'd look at the TV and I'd see Rey Mysterio doing all these like incredible things and winning championships. I'm like, man, I can do that. If he can do that, I can do it, you know? I just saw a lot of what I wanted to be in Rey, in the way that he told his stories in the ring. He was always the underdog. I remember the Biggest Little Man DVD and it's one of my favorites because literally every single match, the way that he is presented, you don't even have to say anything. You just put Rey Mysterio next to somebody and you already know by the way he's looking up at his opponent that it's gonna be an uphill battle to climb, and usually he does it, and you know, it just makes you feel like you can also do it too.
I think all of his teachings kind of came full circle in the summer of Cena, when I got to work about 20 live events with Rey and his son. They kind of let me, from the apron, kind of coach and improvise. And Rey, certainly having the seniority of the group, really just kind of listened. And I remember, talking to his son about options he should choose in the ring and what he should do and how he should act. And Rey is right across from me on the corner. And Rey's like, "Man, why didn't you teach me any of this stuff?" And without a second of hesitation, I said, "Rey, because you taught me this." He taught that to me and was so grateful that I was teaching it to his son. It was really cool to be able to not only digest his advice, but apply it to another generation of WWE superstars beyond myself.
It's so impressive how you see this big legend being so humble. Nobody in the world, and I can sign you right here, right now, that nobody hates Rey Mysterio. You will never hear something bad about Rey Mysterio. If you ask 100 people, "Hey, what do you think of Rey Mysterio?" All of them are gonna have good opinions. Like, you wouldn't, I can sign you that, you wouldn't hear anything bad from him.
I mean, I'm sure you can ask anybody who's ever met him. He just, in general, is cool, down to earth, nice, kind, gentle, compassionate. They say don't meet your heroes, but like meeting my heroes and meeting someone like Rey and seeing how he is as a person and how you make people feel is everything. And the way he makes people feel is just amazing. And so like that's something that I want to continue to do for not just, you know, people who look up to me or any, but just anybody in general.
He just nitpicks to where he wants me to be better than he was. But that's so hard, man. That's so hard to fill those shoes and even just to be able to attempt it. But I think overall, just the best advice was, you know, be yourself out there and give the people 110% you have, because that's all you can do. Give them the best you can do.
We got the team in Europe a few years ago, and that was really special to me. And actually, after the match, this picture was taken, and to this day, it's in my favorites on my phone. I just love that picture, and you know, when my career is done and I actually take the time to maybe put some stuff of my career up on my walls at home or something, that picture is gonna be there for sure. I remember feeling like it was so surreal that I got to team with him. Just getting to travel with him, I guess it was probably our first tour. I think we were in Europe. It's probably our first tour together. And just hearing that I was gonna get to team with him just filled me with so much joy. And then, you know, having that moment after the match was just really special.
I've seen the same barber for the last 15 years, and he's a man with a Hispanic background, and the way he talks about Eddie Guerrero and Rey Mysterio, the light that is in his eyes, the smile that comes to his face, and the way his kids, who didn't get to watch them perform years ago, still know who they are, I can't explain to you how awesome. I can only imagine how Rey Mysterio feels, but that's what I strive for, that's what I want, and to see not just a cultural, but a generational impact that he's had. He's synonymous with not only his culture and his people, but in the world of wrestling.
I mean, he's the definition of the greatest to ever do it, in my opinion. You know, he opened so many doors. He revolutionized the sport. He brought Lucha Libre to the United States and changed the world of wrestling. Simple as that. And I don't want to get too deep into it, but he's definitely one of the best little men to ever do it, and definitely opened the doors for tons of people. And he's a genuine GOAT.
Rey's legacy in a few words: impossible is nothing. By lineup standards, Rey Mysterio shouldn't exist, and he's one of the most decorated superstars in WWE history. Someone would look at Rey Mysterio and be like, "Impossible." To him, it's just a word.